Most gracious Heavenly Father, we just thank you for a beautiful day, Lord. A day that we can rejoice and be glad in it. We just thank so thankful for each one and every one that's here this day, Lord. Pray you'll bless in a mighty way, Lord. Help us to never take our eyes off of you, Lord. But when we take our eyes off of you, things will change. So I just pray that we'll stay focused on what you've done for us as we sang the song, that you've died for us. And Lord, I just pray that we'll never forget what you've done for us, and that we will persevere through it all to be what you've called us to be, the witness in a lost world. So open our hearts, open our minds as we go into your word this day. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. We look around, look at situations, look at everything that's going on, but you realize God still has it all in control. There's not a single thing that catches him off guard. Not a single thing. He knows us from the top of our heads to the soles of our feet. He knows what we're thinking even at this point in time right now. I hope the pastor's quick today. It's going to get hot outside. We need to get home. No, you're probably not thinking that. But if you were, God knows. That's what we have to realize. God knows our thoughts. Do you allow your thoughts to line up with the Word of God? Or does your thoughts just kind of go over here? Well, they're my thoughts. No. God listens and hears each and everything. All thoughts. All the words that come out of our mouth. All the actions that we do. Everything that we do, God knows. And the old saying is, God knows what goes on behind closed doors. You realize that? God knows. Who are we here to please? God. Who are we here to lift up? Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, for what he's done for us. It's all about the journey. And the journey can be a good journey. Do you have to get excited? Do you have to get angry along life's journey? No, you do not. You can put a smile on your face and say one thing, and you can put a smile on your face and say another thing, or you can frown and look like you hate the world and say the same words, and it will receive totally different than what you maybe even meant it to be said. We are to allow what? Christ's light to shine through us. It's not about us. The only thing about us is the journey. Where will we spend eternity? Heaven or hell? And that is the only choice you really have in life. Do you realize that? Heaven or hell. God knows what's going on. He says, I got your back. You're covered under the blood of Jesus Christ. We're all covered. Not just a pastor, not just a deacon, but not just the members of the church. We're all covered under the blood of God, of Jesus Christ, that love Jesus and have submitted ourselves to his will, his perfect way. If we submit ourselves to him, we can be what he's called us to be, a witness in a lost world. We're going to start over the Psalms. I already started, but over in Psalms chapter 2. Retract that. We're going to go to Psalms 3, chapter verse 1. Lord, how art they increased that trouble me? Many are they that rise up against me. Do you feel like the world is against you? You're probably right. Because we're living in a lost world. And when you allow your light to shine, what does that do? That shows them where they are at. So do they like people that allow their light to shine around them? I'd like to invite you to church. Well, you've invited me 1,000 times and I'm still not going to go. But they're going to stand accountable for what they do, as we will. We'll stand accountable. I'm excited about each and every one that's here today. Praise the Lord. We're here for a purpose. Not to hear a pastor preach, but to hear the Word of God. That's what it's all about. It's about the Word of God. A word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against God. And that's why we're here to learn how much he loves us. He says, verse 2, it says, many there be which say of my soul, there is no hope for him in God. How many people have you heard people say that about someone? There is no hope for them. Man, they're sinners, they're lost, they're going to hell, and there is no hope. But there's always hope through Jesus Christ. But it's a choice. And that's what he said earlier. It's a choice. There is no help for him and God. Yes, there is. That's the only hope. And that's the only help we have is through God that sent his son to die on the cross for you and me. When you feel like nobody cares in your mind, if you want, just shut your eyes and just visualize the cross that Christ died for you and me. And if you was the only lost person on the face of the earth, he would have died for you anyhow to make a way out of no way. His love is unconditional. And in verse 3, it's, "But thou, O Lord, are a shield for me." Do you know him? If you know him, he's your shield. What can man do unless God allows it? And if man does something, God may be allowing it just for a week and learn something through it. But he's our shield. And when you got the shield, do you use it? But some of all these little kids start throwing rocks at you, you raise your shield up. Then when they get done, you get your board and go out there and whoop them. They don't do it no more. Sounds silly. We need a whipping once in a while, people. We need a whipping because we've taken our eyes off of Jesus Christ and we put them upon ourselves. It's all about me and not about Jesus Christ. How many thought, man, it's so hot outside and it's going to be hotter when we get it done preaching. I don't know if I really want to be out in that. I'm probably not physically able to walk to the car and turn the air conditioner on, get in the car and drive to church and get out of the car and walk into an air conditioning building. Who are we lying to? We're lying to self. Thousands of people are lying to themselves and they're believing their own lies. People, I'd rather have put my faith and my trust in my Lord and Savior. And if I was to die from the heat, I'd rather die in the house of the Lord than out there on a riverbank trying to catch fish. And they're not biting. It's too hot. But what are we doing? We're sitting out there trying to catch them anyhow. Open our eyes. Keep your eyes fixed upon Jesus Christ. "But thou, O Lord, art a shield for me, my glory, and the lifter up of my head." He lifts our head up. The Bible says we don't have to run around in gloom and despair. Man, it just everything's falling apart. I don't know what I'm going to do. Turn it over to the Lord. And he's probably got something better for you than what you're trying to get back. Just have faith in him. You had faith in him to come today, and the weather hasn't overtaken you yet, and the air conditioner is still working. That's awesome.
We have one.
We have one. We have two. I hope we have two. Okay, I'm making sure. But we know what the enemy tries to do, and he's a liar from the pits of hell, and God turns everything around for the good of those that love the Lord. And he lifts our head up. How many people do you know run around in gloom and despair? Maybe you just need, God told me to help you lift your head up. I'd like to invite you to church. I'd like to encourage you. Can I pray for you? You ever pray for somebody you just don't know and just felt led of the Holy Spirit to pray? Well, no, I'm not that type of person. Well, you better be. You're a child of the King. Jesus, before he knew you, stretched forth his arms. He loved you that much. He says in verse 4, he says, "I cried unto the Lord with my voice, and he heard me out of his holy hill." When you cry out to God, he hears it all. He hears us when we speak. He hears everything we're thinking. He knows everything we're thinking. He knows everything that goes on behind closed doors. He knows it all. But as his children, when we cry out to him, does he hear us? I don't think so, because he didn't answer my prayer. Well, you don't need ice cream first thing in the morning. You know he's not going to answer that prayer. You do not need to go through problems and situations. We need God. We need to have faith in him. And when he answers these prayers, all we got to do is keep our eyes fixed and open and say, "I understand now. You want me to do this, and you've revealed to me the purpose." Has God talked to you about inviting somebody to church? And you say, I'm a shy person. I leave that up to the pastor. I leave that up to the deacons. I leave that up to other people. The Bible never once told us that. He says, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel. He's talking about each and every one of us. Go ye and preach the gospel, baptizing in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. We have purpose. He says in verse 5, he says, I lay me down and sleep. I wait, for the Lord sustain me. And I'm assuming that everybody that laid down and went to sleep last night, I know we're here, but I hope everybody else is still alive and still have an opportunity. But this is what the Word says. He says, I awake, for the Lord sustains me. He's given you the wisdom and the knowledge and guiding you, and He's right there with you. Love. If you have an issue and you come up, say, Pastor, can I talk to you for a minute? No, I'm kind of busy today. Maybe next week. You'd say, huh? God says, yes, I want to hear you. Speak to me. Tell me what you're needing. And He will lead us and guide us and direct us in the way that we should go. We have to stay focused upon who we are in the Lord. I'm going to jump over to Psalms 139, verse 23. And this is what we all need to pray. If you think you haven't got it figured out, you don't know which way to go, you just, I think I'm doing okay. I hope I'm doing okay. Listen, search me, O God. Psalms, David. Whoever wrote it is probably David, but he says, search me, O God. Maybe we ought to pray that the first thing in the morning. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Does God know your heart? He does. Try me. How many has went through obstacles and situations? Man, I didn't care about going through that at all this week. And he says, try me. So if you're going through something and you think it just, man, it just don't seem right. Maybe God is trying you to show me where I'm at. Them fingers go all the way around. Try me, Lord. Is He trying you? And I've heard different testimonies along the way, and I know God is trying people, but all we can do is stand upon the Word of God. God says, I have it in control. And we might not see it now, and it might look like it's going just north, and we want to go south. He's got it in control. And when we travel a road that He set before us, then we can see the salvation of the Lord and the purpose. He never once said, I'm going to tell you the purpose. I'm going to tell you where you're going. I'm going to tell you how many people you're going to share with. He's not telling us anything. He just said, go. And we allow the Holy Spirit to lead us. And know my thoughts. Try me and know my thoughts. What's going on in your mind right now? Wouldn't it be awesome if everybody had to say exactly what's going on through your mind right now and you had to come up here and stand in front of everybody and say, well, I was thinking about breakfast this morning. It was kind of cold. I was thinking about, well, it's kind of warm in here today. I was thinking about, are you thinking about Jesus Christ that died for us? It says, know my thoughts. Kind of scary, isn't it? God knows it all. Kind of scary. And so if you're going through something and you said, man, I'm going, it feels like hell itself. I'm going through it right now and I don't know what to do. Maybe God's trying to show you where you're at and what you need to do. Turn your eyes back to Him and be what He's called us to be. And see if there be any wicked way in me and lead me in the way everlasting. If there's any wicked way in us, Lord, reveal it to us. Confess it. He's faithful and just to forgive us of our sins. We confess it. And then he will lead. He says, lead me in the way everlasting. And where is the way everlasting lead? Throne of God. Heaven bound. How many here today? It's heaven bound. How many here today? It says, I know that I know that I know I'm heaven bound. Or do you just say, I hope, I hope, I hope I'm heaven bound. Sounds funny. You'd be surprised when you share with enough people who say, well, I hope I'm going to heaven. I don't serve a hope so God. I serve a know so God. We'll jump over to Micah chapter 7, verse 7. The prophet at this time, here's what he's saying. Therefore, I will look unto the Lord. Where are you looking for your strength? We look to the Lord. How many is promised tomorrow? Not a single one of us. Brother over here hit a deer. And I've seen people hit deer in totally different situation, not make it through. Or a brother sitting here. When did you hit that deer? Friday? A week ago Friday? And yet, he's in the house of the Lord. Has he still got to make some pains? A little bit? There you go. God has purpose. And he said, let your light so shine. He says, therefore I will look unto the Lord. I will wait for the God of my salvation. Are you waiting for him? Or do you have anxiety attacks? I've got to get it done now. Wait on the Lord. His timing is perfect. Our timing is off base. Wait on the Lord. He says, I will wait for God of my salvation. My God will hear me. He will hear us. He knows our thoughts. He knows us from the top of our heads to the soles of our feet. He knows everything about us. You want to know something about yourself? Start praying. Say, God, reveal to me where I'm at. Reveal to me what I need to change. And you might, if you're earnestly praying, you might be surprised of what he says. Well, I don't believe you can physically hear him. I do. He works in mysterious ways. Do I have them all figured out? No, but I know. I remember that day he called me to go to the altar. And I know it was his voice and not my own, because that was not me, but Christ that wants to be in me. Be what he's called you to be, a witness. In verse 8 it says, rejoice not against me, O my enemy, when I fall, I shall rise. The enemy is, he's so happy. When he sees one of the saints, everything falling apart around him, he's just as happy as can be. But if you want to make him really unhappy, put a smile on your face and God's got it in control. He's always taking care of me, and he's not going to turn his back on me now because I love him with all my heart. I've shared before, I've had times when didn't know what we was going to do. And somebody comes in, and we was really selling cars at that time, and come in and says, will you take two cars for that car? And I looked at what he had, looked at mine, I said, sir, one of your cars is probably worth more than my car. And he chases me. He says, I did not ask you that. He says, I ask you, will you take two cars for that car? And we needed it more than ever to pay bills. And I said, yes, we will. God was there working through it all. But we have to continue to allow our light to shine. Because you'd be surprised how many people say, you cannot be a car dealer and sell cars and be a Christian. Oh, really? Why not? Because it's all about the dollar. I said, nope. I tell everybody, if they say, what do you know about this car? Everything I know and think I might know, I told them. I told them. You can be in any type of business, as long as it's a legitimate business, as long as it's not contrary to the Word of God, and God will take care of your needs. And you say, well, I did all that and the door shut. But are you in a better place now than you was? God has purpose. Have faith in Him. Have trust in Him. Look what God has done. That's all we got to say. Look what God has done. We live in a church. We're going to church here, debt-free. When we built the addition, we didn't owe nobody. We're looking and saying, how are we going to pay for all this? When we get done, then we don't owe nothing, next to nothing if we owed anything. God took care of us because why? We kept our eyes upon Him. Purpose. Rejoice not against me, O my enemy. When I fall, I shall arise. When I sit in darkness, the Lord shall be the light unto me. Man, if it looks like darkness, everything's going falling apart, your light is still shining because of who you are. You're a child of the King. One day you said, yes, Lord, I want you in my heart. I want you as my Lord and Savior. And wherever you lead me, I will go. Through the good, bad, some things look really bad. But when God gets there and you get through it, you say, man, I couldn't have worked it out any better than what God has done. All I can do is have faith in Him. Where's your faith? In our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We jump over to Romans. Chapter 8, verse 26. Likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities. And we got God the Father, God the Son, and the Holy Spirit working for us too. Man, we got the Trinity working on our behalf. Do you realize that? That's what it says. He says, likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities, for we know not what we should pray for as we ought. And if we really got down on our knees and we allow God to reveal to us, we'd be praying for the United States of America. This country's falling apart. We would thank Him that we're living in an area that we don't feel that the heaviness that's going on in the world. Can we? Yep, we could. But we fix our eyes upon Him. He says, but the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. The Holy Spirit groaning. We cannot even understand it. We think we're praying. We're down on our knees going, oh, Lord, oh. And the Holy Spirit interprets that to God. God, they need a touch from you today. God, they're crying from their heart. They need to feel your presence. We need to trust in God and who we are. In verse 27, and he that searcheth the heart knoweth what is in the mind of the Spirit, because he maketh intercessions for the saints according to the will of God. The Trinity. Holy Spirit's working within you. God interprets each and everything that we say through the Holy Spirit. God knows our feelings. He knows our thoughts. He knows when we're playing a game and when we're not. We cannot fool God. So many people say, well, I go to church every Sunday. All right. Why? Aren't you the one that's sleeping every Sunday? Why do you go? Well, they don't know. We come for a purpose. To get energized, to get excited, to go out to a lost world and let the world know that they need Jesus. You're going to run into people that's going to hell that some saints might ever never see, but they're going to hell, and God has sent you as a messenger to erase any excuse they might have. Well, nobody ever shared with me. I don't know. On Judgment Day, all kind of like a camera. Everything's going to be revealed. Our heart's thoughts, our heart's feelings, our mind thoughts, the whole nine yards are going to be revealed. No, this is why you did not share with that person. And our mind's thoughts, I believe, will be right there in front of us. We have no excuse. We're on the best team there is. We're on the team of Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Could have sent 10,000 angels, but he died alone for you and me. So what do you think them angels might be doing right now? Watching over us. To allow nothing to happen to you unless it's in God's will. But what if I die? Absent from the body, present with the Lord. What more do you got to ask for? Man, start looking at the Word of God for what it is. It's our hope that we have in Him. In verse 28, and we know that all things work together for the good to them that love God, to them who are they called according to His purpose. Purpose for you. Never think of yourself as anything but what God has called you to be. You're a child of the King. Well, I'm no good for nothing. Nobody likes me. God loves you. Nobody cares for me. Jesus stretched forth His arms for you. Well, I don't have nobody to encourage me along the way. The Holy Spirit lives within you and encourages you. If you would just allow Him to speak and listen to that. The Bible says, listen to that still small voice. That's the Holy Spirit speaking in us. We should be the happiest people on the face of the earth. I know I say that quite often, but we should be. And if things are falling apart around you, guess what? Oh, that tree fell down. That tree fell down. Oh, doesn't matter. I'm standing on a solid rock. What do I have to fear but fear itself? That's what they said when we had the war a long time ago. What do we have to fear but fear itself? And fear has no boundaries. It has no control over us unless we open ourselves up to it. From now on, when the enemy starts lying to you, say, God has purpose. Well, your car is going to break down before you get there. God has purpose. And that purpose might just be to pick somebody up, and they might just say, man, I sure appreciate you stopping by. I just felt led of the Holy Spirit. You're a believer? And you have the opportunity to share Jesus Christ. You ever been there? You ever break down along the road? Not break down, just pull off and stop. And somebody up on a hill, stopped up on the hill, got out of their car and come down to see if everything was okay. A believer, is everything okay? God has purpose. He was just checking that guy to see if he's going to listen to that still small voice. And he was just checking me to make sure I was going to stand up on who I was, who I am, not was. I'm not a was. Okay, understand, I am not a was. I am an am right now. Okay? In verse 31, it says, what shall we then say to these things? Listen close. Hide it within your heart. If God be for us, who can be against us? If God's for you, who can be against you? The world can hate you. But it's not a God hate. It's a worldly hate. I'd rather have one person that loved me more than anything else than a world that worshiped me. I'd rather have that one person, one Jesus Christ, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, pleasing to them than I am to a world. We have purpose. This week, I challenge each and every one of you. This week, start looking at people as Jesus Christ looked at them. Are they saved or are they lost? And if you do not know if they're saved, befriend them. Not defriend, befriend them. Be a friend to them. Gotta get that straight. Oh, nope. Be a friend to them. Invite them to church. And if they cuss you out enough times, then you know where they're going to spend eternity. Allow your light so shine. Why in the world would Jesus Christ call a person like me, a body of believers, to go out there and save a world? We have purpose. And it started with Jesus Christ. He did this, why? To save a world. And it was a choice. Choose you this day who you will serve. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. It's a choice. And when he did this, past, present, and future, we have no excuse not to follow him. None whatsoever. So I'm telling you, next time you lie to yourself, say, Satan, get thee behind me. I'm not going to listen to you. I'm going to follow my Lord and Savior, and I'm going to do what he's told me to do, to be a witness in a lost world. Wouldn't it be awesome if just one person of everybody that's here today, one person come back and say, I did what you said, and they accepted Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. Or God is fulfilling what he said he will do, but he chose to use you and me. So I'm telling you, if your heart's not right, if you're off base, if you need to get back on that straight and narrow, we're going to open the altar up. That's what the altar is for. You don't have to come up and tell the pastor anything. You just come up and tell God, God, I need to change. It's not all about me. It's all about what you call me to do, a witness. So open your hearts and open your minds to be what he's called you to be. Shall we all stand?